Yes, just another day here in World of Tanks. We are going to maybe move over here, try and intercept the mediums and lights over on the 9-0 line, although don't have a lot of support. Not getting a lot of support. Okay, well, we're not going to hang around too long. We'll set up here, see what we spot, get a few shots in. There's a Cromwell. There's a Cromwell reduced to 200 hit points. That's grand. Oh, okay, Panther M10, that's another 409 damage, looking good, but I don't have a lot of support. T-34-85 just north of me on the mini-map, and there's a T-29 coming back. He sees the danger. He sees the danger. He's coming back to support. Awesome! So, just gonna hang here until the T-29 on the mini-map moves up. And just an M10 and a Cromwell over here. No pressure. Oh, there's a Bulldog. Now there's pressure. And the T-34-85 has gone down, so we've got to relocate. And I need that T-29. The T-29's actually got my back. Okay, he's got my back. So he's going to shoot anything coming up the C line. And I'm just going to defend this corner here. No, where are you going, T-29? T-29's relocating. Oh, crap. And now it's too late for me to relocate. Right, well, at least the T-29 sees the danger. We'll put another shot into the Panther M10. I really hope I don't get flanked. No, I got flanked, but at least the T-29 can protect my ass. No, too light, I'm dead. And our where are you going, T-29? T-29, where are you going? You could have had my back. yeah, okay, full health T-29. Okay. Hi folks, and welcome to the Ace Tanker for the Ordnance QF 25-pounder on Carrier Valentine 25-pounder Mark 1. Otherwise known as the Bishop. Thankfully, they changed its name, which makes it much, much easier to talk about, or gave it a nickname, I should say. But this is the Tier 5 British Artillery. As I say, I've been going up the low-tier Brits, finally got around to playing the artillery years after they were introduced into the game, and this is as far as I got. So, you know, those arty haters out there are probably going to be loving the fact that I'm going to say that this is probably the last arty replay you're going to see in quite some time, because I finished with the grind, I unlocked the tier 6, I just haven't got around to buying Bert yet. I will eventually, but I've pretty much had it with Arty. I'm currently grinding French Arty at the moment, and it's the only Arty I kind of want to play. I've got far other things, or better things I want to do with my time. So anyway, this is the first Ace. We are here on Swamp, and the Bishop story is very, very intertwined with previous videos and previous history I've talked about, because at the beginning of World War II, despite being, you know, the inventors pretty much of the SPG, or inventing some of the first SPGs ever, regarding the Birch gun 20 years earlier, when World War II began, Britain didn't really have any SPGs. They had artillery, but like most nations, they were horse-drawn or they were towed artillery. They didn't have any mobile artillery, SPGs, and the changing face of tank warfare in World War II was that, you know, they needed to be mobile. Tank warfare advanced very, very quickly. It was about thrusts and counter thrusts, and basically, there was definitely a need for an SPG, and Britain didn't have any. So they approached the Birmingham Railway Carriage and Wagon Company, a company that I've talked about previously, because they were the company that they built the Valentine, they built the Churchill, they built the cruiser, but they were also the company behind the design and development, so they designed and developed the Cromwell, along with Rolls-Royce. So they've been talked about on the channel before, but as I say, in 1941, Britain needed SPGs, so they approached the Birmingham Railway Carriage and Wagon Company and said, can you do something for us? Can you mount a 25-pounder on a tank? And the company said, yeah, we'll give it a go. And just 2 months later, in August, the prototype was built, it was trialed, and it passed its trials. Not terribly successfully, but well well enough for the British government to basically order 100 bishops to be built. It was called a bishop because it was felt that the turret on top of the Valentine II was a it looked like a bishop's hat. So that's pretty much where the ecclesiastical name came from. But anyway, as I say, 100 were ordered, 80 were built, another 20 were just finishing production, about to come off the production lines, when the US entered World War II. Now, the US were able to supply M7 Priests, well, the M7 howitzer motor carriage, which the British renamed the Priest, and it was far, far better than the Bishop. So even though there was an order for an extra 250 of these to be built, the order was cancelled, with just 100 being built in favour of the M7 Priest, and then later in favour of the Sexton. So this is a tier 5 British artillery, and it was replaced by the tier 3 British artillery, the Sexton 1 and the Sexton 2. So I don't know what else to say. It wasn't a very successful design, but it did the job. It was mainly used in North Africa during the North African campaign. It was also used in Italy, but the problems with the Bishop were that it was just far too slow. It was built on a Valentine II, and it was also used in the desert. And, you know, having a very, very big, tall tank with a very, very high profile is usually not good, especially in a desert. So it meant they were very, very slow, very, very easy to take out, very, very easy to spot. Hence, the British were more than happy to replace it with the M7 Priest. And after the Sexton came online, the Bishop was, well, it stayed in action. I won't say it stayed in action. It basically stayed in service up till the end of World War II. But once the Sexton came along, it basically replaced the Bishop, and the Bishop was relegated to training duty. So it was used for training. But it did see combat up till the Sexton arrived. Anyway, there we go. That's the history. We are going to go in-game. This is a tank that I only have HE on it. Now, it doesn't seem to come with AP in the game, which is kind of strange, because in real life, one of the benefits of the Bishop was that it had AP. But in game, we've got the 25 pounder, we've got 57 millimeters of penetration, which is not amazing considering this tank sees tier 7s, and 450 damage, which again, not amazing because it sees tier 7s. The gun arc, or the range of fire, is incredibly small, which means you've got to move this slow, not very good camo, high profile target quite close to the enemy in order to get shots. But when you do manage to move up and you do manage to get shots, what you end up having is an artillery that is very, very accurate and can lay down fire extremely quickly. So we've moved up, had to move up, and you can see that those tanks over there are out of range, but there are tanks hiding behind this rock that are in range. I go for a blind shot. And this is the nice thing about the Bishop. It's got an incredibly high firing arc. You can see that the Leo has taken some damage there. Not sure if that was me, but incredibly high firing arc, incredibly fast rate of fire, having to move forward in order to get my gun on target because the range of fire is not good, and the shell velocity is not very fast either. But I didn't hate the Bishop. I found it was a little bit situational, but when you can get it into position and are able to start raining down shots, it's incredibly effective. I'm imagining if this gun is on the Burt at tier 6 and you get the speed and mobility of the Burt, then the Burt's going to be a lot of fun. So we end up taking out the Panzer T-25. And I'm shooting higher tier tanks, so I'm at bottom tier here. I'm a tier 5 and a tier 7 game. And I'm shooting tier 7s, and that's always fun and always nice. And you can see that the aim time is quite good, the accuracy is quite good. We do another 425 on the side of the SU-12244. So I'm going to finish off this tier 5, or tier 7. Oh, he stopped. Put a shot in. And yes, we are. So rate of fire, gun arc, very, very nice. And when you can hit lightly armored targets, you can do a lot of damage. And this ace is a result of me hitting. Oh, I thought that would have been a hit on the SU-100Y, but this ace is a result of doing a lot of damage to tier 7s. Hitting a lot of tier 7s, doing a lot of damage to tier 7s, higher tier tanks, leads to more XP and more credits. We go for a couple of blind shots on the area where the SU was, but now I'm kind of stuck because I need enemy tanks to advance. Go for another blind shot. So, okay, no shots on the Rudy, and have to readjust. In the meantime, oh, nope, never mind. Black Prince has appeared. He has moved forward into my firing arc just about. No, he hasn't. And there's the problem with the bishop. You know, the range of fire, it's just a little bit lacking, but it looks as if someone's been hitting the SU-100Y again. It may have been a little bit of blind damage by me, but firing before being fully aimed, and boom. Penetration, which is kind of surprising, because the SU-100Y is 60mm of armor all round, and as I say, I only have 57mm of penetration, so that was a very, very high RNG roll to take out the SU-100Y. So, but anyway, we're continuing to work. Enemy heavies are starting to advance, and I'm going to try and put a shot into the IS. And that was a lovely, lovely shot, even though the damage wasn't particularly high. Because of the long shell time in the air, you really, really have to judge your shots quite well. And that one wasn't. You see how long it took for the shot to reach? Even though I'm relatively close to this IS by RT standards, it just took forever for that shot to land or to reach the target. So, gotta see if we can get another one. Oh, just missed. So, still a Black Prince and an IS down here. The team are winning 10-7, so quite comfortable. I'm on 3 kills. And nope. Shell arc, the shell arc is good enough. The splash damage radius is not particularly good, as you would expect from a 25-pounder. But we put another shot in, and that one was good. Only 94 damage, but, yeah, I'm wondering, do I have to relocate now? Should I relocate? Do I have to relocate? But, yeah, there's a Black Prince down here, and I kind of want to put shots into the Black Prince, because if I can hit the Black Prince, he's slow-moving, and, you know, I can keep him perma-track, but go for a shot before being fully aimed. And just have a hint of a shot here, and you can see the rate of fire is good. The reload is good, but he gets taken out, so we don't get to kill an IS. So, moving up, and the camo rating of this tank is not amazing. Enemy bishop is spotted, and there's a Black Prince, and there we go. I've just been spotted, although I haven't known it yet because I don't have a very good crew in this, but we fire before being fully aimed. Take another hit from the Black Prince. Miss, the enemy bishop decides to focus on me, even though he's being shot by someone else. But we managed to put a couple of shots into the bishop, get some spotting damage, finish him off for kill number 4, and just one enemy tank left, an AMX 13 F3, and it's very, very unlikely I'm going to get anywhere near him or get any more shots, because he'd been hunted down by a Cromwell B and a Type 64. Cromwell B built by the same company as the bishop. So there we go. So first and only ace in the bishop, because even though I enjoyed the artillery, I enjoyed the rate of fire, I enjoyed the accuracy, I enjoyed being an annoying little twat when I was playing it, the fact of the matter is it's a little bit too slow, the camo rating's awful, and you have as many bad games in this RT as you do good games. And once again, being RT, you're very, very team dependent. So even though I didn't hate it, I sold it because I just don't see myself playing it again. And I'm going to wait until I have more credits and until I have more patience before moving on to tier 6. I have been looking to forward to playing the BERT for a long, long time, but I just, right now I've got better things to focus on. So we picked up the ace, we picked up the Starks medal for while driving an SPG, destroy 2 enemy vehicles and destroy 2 or receive 2 enemy hits that are blocked or by armor or cause damage. I have to survive. Damage received by my vehicle must be 2/3 of the hit points, no problems. And hitting allied vehicles is not counted, unfortunately. But yeah, so Stark's medal in the bishop. 1044 XP required for the ace, 1972, almost 2k damage done. So quite happy considering I'm a tier 5, tier 7 game. And this is why RT isn't balanced. The fact that you can always be 2 tiers lower than the tanks you're shooting, and you can still have an amazing impact regarding damage wise and being able to annoy the enemy team. So 4 kills, 18 shots fired, we managed to land 9 hits, 9 penetrations, 3 splash damage, even though the tank has no splash damage, but happy with the damage. 6 damage, 4 destroyed, and 308 assistance damage. So not as much assistance damage, not much tracking of enemy tanks, but just being annoying. And running a premium consumable means I ended up with just a profit of 12,000 credits. It was the first game of the day, so it's a x2, and yeah, overall quite happy with the result, happy with the tank, but just not enough to keep it, or happy with the artillery I should say, just not enough to keep it. But yeah, it's not terrible. Anyway, there we go. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time.